time, I really, really miss you. I do. I miss all of you. I hope you all are doing well. I really do. I mean, I know this social distancing and this pandemic it can be overwhelming and challenging for many. But just know this, I'm here for you. If any of you want to talk to me or you need some guidance or anything, hit me up on Facebook. Or you can email me. I'm going to put my email down at the bottom of the screen so that you can, you know, email me. And also I'll put my Facebook Messenger on there. So feel free anytime. Even if it's just to say hi. It don't have to be nothing of importance. I would love to hear from you all. I've already spoken to many of you already. You know, feel free to share anything. You want to share a video with me or whatever. That'd be so cool. I had a student that sent me his artwork and it was just awesome. I'm like, I didn't realize he had, you know, that extra talent. You know, I'm like, wow, you're a great artist. And so feel free, whatever you want to share, feel free to send that to me. I would love to hear from you. Alrighty, well, this is the reason why I'm making this video, because I don't want you to stop learning music. Music is everywhere. You know, you can't go anywhere without music, pretty much. You can't even watch TV without hearing some type of song in the background. When you're watching a movie, you hear the music. If you're at Kroger or something like that, you hear music playing. So music is all around us, and I just don't want you to stop learning it. So today, what I want to do, I want to teach you how to read music. Yes, many of you I've already started with, and so this will be a review for you so that you won't forget. But some of you I didn't get a chance to teach you how to read music because of all this stuff that's happening in our world today. So today you're gonna learn how to read music. You ready? All right, come on, join me. All right, so the first thing when you are reading music, okay, when you're reading music, you want to look at the staff. This is the first thing you will see when you're reading music, is the staff. And notice this, in the staff, you will see that there are 5 lines and 4 spaces. So as you can see this, you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You see that? It's right there. The numbers are right there on the line. So if these numbers were actual notes, it would go right in the middle of that line. It is split it in half pretty much. So it's right there on the line. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But there are also 4 spaces. Okay? So look at that. So if this was a note, it would cover that whole space, but it would not go past the line. It wouldn't be like gigantic or anything like that. And it wouldn't be real small. It'd be from the top of the space to the bottom of the space. So there's the first space, the second space, third space, and the fourth space. Okay, so the first line, the lines are 5 lines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And there are 4 spaces. 1, 2, 3, 4, as you can see that. Okay, so those are the main things that you definitely have to know. 5 lines, 4 spaces. So don't forget that part. Okay, that's very important. All right, so now in reading music, there's often a symbol that you will learn. There are many, many other musical symbols, but today we're going to focus on this symbol right here, which is called the G clef or the treble clef. And the reason, you know, it's also called the G clef, it's because it kind of looks like a fancy G, okay? And another reason why they call it the G clef, because this second line right here is actually the note G, okay? And so, and that's where, if I had to draw this treble clef, I would start on the second line, the note G, and wrap it all the way around. You see how you follow my cursor, and you go up, and you come down just like that. All right, so and so that's why they call it the G clef, but the majority of us do call it the treble clef. So in this class, we're going to call this musical symbol a treble clef. And so a treble clef lets the singers and the musicians know that it's upper register. You sing higher, or you play higher. So if I had to, if I saw this as a singer, I'll be like, oh, I gotta sing higher. You know, exciter. So that symbol right there, this symbol right here, lets me know that I'm singing higher, or if I'm playing the piano or trumpet or playing the guitar, I'm playing in the higher register. Okay, so that's another piece that you will see at the beginning of music. Okay, on the staff. Now the next thing, what we're going to learn, we're going to actually learn the notes on the spaces. We're going to learn spaces today. And so here's the treble clef right here. Okay, and then we have the first space, the second space, the third space, and the fourth space. And these notes right here, if you recall, these are whole notes, right? Remember, a whole note is held for four beats. So for those of you that's younger, I teach you the syllables ta, right? So we say ta, right? That's four counts. So I clap on that first beat, and then I don't clap anymore. And so if I was counting, I still clap on that first beat, but I don't clap anymore, but I'm still counting up to four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Now if I'm singing it, I'll be like something like la. You see that? I held it for four counts. I didn't do la, 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 la. I didn't do that, right? Because then it'd be a totally different note. So it's like, it's smooth. La. So I hold it for that four counts. So that is a whole note, okay? Remember that. It's a whole note. So we're going to be looking at these whole notes on the staff. All right, so the first space is always an F. You always start from the bottom and go up, okay? So the first space starts at the bottom and never starts at the top. So remember that. It always starts right here at the bottom. And notice that this whole note, it takes up the top of the space to the bottom of the space. It don't go past the space, and it's not so little either. It fills up that whole space right there. So that first space is F. The second space, one, two, is A. And that third space, one, two, three, is C. And the fourth space is one, two, three, four, is E. Okay, you see that? First space, F. Second space, A. Third space, one, two, three, is C. Fourth space, F, A, C, E, is E. Right, and so look at what it spells. It spells the word it spells the word face. Right, face. All right, so these are the notes that's on the spaces on the staff, the music staff. So F, A, C, E, and then you also see this here. And I also, if you see on this side, I kind of have it just written F, A, C, E. E, so that you can see it in a different light. Okay, F, A, C, E. So that never changes. So if you remember that the F is always the first space, A is always the second, C is the third, and E is always the fourth, then you'll be in good standing. Okay, all right, so F, A, C, E. All right, so, and you remember what this symbol is? What is that symbol? Yes, it's called a G clef, but it's also what we're going to call it is treble clef. If you got it, that's awesome. So remember that symbol is a treble clef. Do you remember what that treble clef is used for? Do you know? What does that tell the singer or musician? Remember? It tells the singer or musician that you sing higher, or you play your notes in a higher register. Okay, remember that as well. So these notes, if I were playing it, would be in a higher register. Alrighty, now let's have some fun. Alright, so Here it is. These aren't really notes, because if they were really notes, then you would put this, they wouldn't be colored in, or if they were colored in, they would have the stems, okay? But these are just dots for now, okay, that we just put on the staff. So what I want you to do is try to find out what these notes are. Now, the F-A-C-E is all mixed up. They're mixed up, okay? Now, we're going to look at these spaces. And we're going to look at these little notes that's placed on these spaces. Now, they're all mixed up. Okay, remember the first space is F, second space is A, third space is C, and fourth space is always right, E. All right, so here we go. All right, so look at this note right here. This time, it's on the second space, right? One, two. So, if we think about it, what is the second space? It's A, right? F, A. All right, let's look at this next one. This time, it's on which space is it on? Huh? One, two, three, four. All right, it's on the fourth space, right? So, F, A, C, E. So, that's the note. It is E. Good, good. Do you know what this note is right here that's on the first space? What note is that? F, that's right, F. All right, let's look at this one. Uh-oh, this one is on the third space. Here we go, F, A, C. Good job, that is a C. All right, here we go, fourth space, F, A, C, E. There's E, look, but it's E right here too. What? Oh my goodness, it's E right there. And when you look all the way down here, there is an E again. See what I mean? The E always stays the same. Same with the F and the A and the C. They're all the same. However, what music is all about, they just mix all the notes, you know, they just scramble them. That's all they do. Music always repeats itself in some way or form. And that's what makes music so interesting. And then you have to be creative in how to switch the notes around to make a new melody. Okay? So, I'm going to leave this here. I'm going to put this link in the at the bottom. I'm trying to put it at the bottom. If not, I'll send it to you via email or whatnot. That way, you can, you know, try to do this yourself and see how well you do. Okay? So, that's the first lesson of learning how to read music, okay? So practice this, alrighty? And I'll put all these up, you know, for you so that you can review them as well, okay? Alrighty, so please keep in touch. Alrighty, stay safe, okay? And just, you know, be encouraged, alright? I'm here if you need me. Alrighty, take care.